What are the results of Kazakhstan's OSCE chairmanship? The topic was discussed on Tuesday in Almaty by representatives of non-governmental organizations.
Kazakhstan's civil sector decided to organize another forum of NGOs on the eve of the most eagerly awaited political events of the year, the OSCE summit. The event will once again assess the results of Kazakhstan's chairmanship in the organization. 2 days of debates involving authorities should produce some answers, including why the dialogue between the government and NGOs ended up in a stalemate and who doesn't play by the rules. The NGOs who are ready for the discussion say there is no clear understanding in the country of what results of the Kazakh chairmanship should be assessed. The aggressively patriotic position of the officials set off the tone of the entire debate. The way we addressed some of the challenges of our chairmanship is evidence that the chair was, and still is, at the high level. The key issue of whether Kazakhstan passes the test of maturity will likely remain unanswered, as officials rigorously avoid it. They see the chairmanship itself as a proof enough of the democratic majority. NGOs disagree. We're discussing whether Kazakhstan passes the test of maturity, but I believe there was no such task at all. The goal of the political elite was to obtain the chairmanship just as a project for the improvement of image, paid for with a lot of money from the state budget from 2003 until now. It was revealed during one of the discussions that this money was also allocated for the promotion of declarative documents, such as the president's address to the nation. Officials talked of its usefulness, while public activists had other issues on their minds. If the authorities want to build a really democratic state as they have declared and openly chose these principles, then it should support NGOs without a judgment. Dr. Tumenova believes Kazakhstan still has a chance to choose the right way from the development of the civil sector. After all, a correct diagnosis equals to a half of successful treatment. Unfortunately, though, the patient doesn't want to admit he requires one.
An attempt of the unregistered party ALGA to host a roundtable on the interaction of NGOs, mass media and government failed on Tuesday in Simi. Following the long-standing tradition, officials simply ignored the event organized by an oppositional party.
State officials from Simei openly displayed their reluctance to communicate with journalists and representatives of NGOs. They ignored the roundtable on the cooperation of state bodies with NGOs and mass media. Event organizers, the activists of the unregistered party ALGA, were not surprised by the behavior of the authorities. ALGA members claimed that officials, both regional and central, respond only to state-controlled media. The roundtable was practically sabotaged as local officials didn't want to listen to alternative opinions. They're afraid to hear the truth from us. They want to hear only what they want to hear, and not what is going on in reality. Despite the officials' ignorance, the participants of the roundtable drafted a document about the freedom of speech. The initiators believe it is necessary to create equal conditions for information access and rid the selectivity towards press. At the same time, it was noted that state officials of any rank must provide information to all interested persons. The roundtable participants intend to present their concept to the OSCE representatives during the review conference, which will be held in Astana on the eve of the summit.
These are all the top news from Kazakhstan. Join us tomorrow for more. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.